Situated on the island of Srirangam, cradled by the rivers Kaveri and Kollidam, the Srirangananda Swami temple, dedicated to Lord Vishnu, is one of the oldest and most important temples in India. It spans a very vast area and is studded with gopurams, mandapams, prakarams and sanctums, far more in number than any other temple in India. In the center is the sanctum sanctorum, crowned by the gold-plated vimanam, which houses the presiding deity, Sri Ranganatha Swami, reclining on the serpent Adisesha. This huge temple complex has 21 entrance gateways, gopurams, many pillared halls, mandapams, and 7 concentric enclosures or prakaras, crowning it as the Uttamottama type of temple architecture, the best there can be. It is believed that the Sriranga Vimana with the image of Ranganatha arose from the ocean as a result of the penance of Lord Brahma. When Sri Rama returned to Ayodhya for his coronation, the Sriranga Vimana was gifted to Vibhishana by Rama for being a faithful friend. Vibhishana, on his way to Lanka with this precious gift, rested for a while on the banks of the river Kaveri. He placed the Vimana on the ground, and when he tried to lift it up, found to his disappointment that it was stuck to the ground. He was informed by Dharmavarman, the ruler of this area, that Ranganatha wanted to stay back on the banks of the Kaveri, but in order to give darshan to Vibhishana, would lie down facing south in the direction of Lanka. With patronage by successive dynasties, the Pallava, Pandya, Hoysala, Chera, surviving tumultuous invasions by the Sultanate of Delhi, to the glorious resurrection by the emperors of Vijayanagara and the Madurai Nayaka rulers, the Ranganatha Swami temple has stood the test of time as a resplendent jewel in the firmament of Vaishnavite temples. The conservation project at the Sri Ranganatha Swami temple was of considerable magnitude and undeniable urgency. Within this vast precinct, there was clear evidence of dilapidation that had changed the very nature and energy of this glorious temple. The accumulation of debris due to natural and man-made causes, the stagnation of water, subsequent dampness, the resultant damage of structures, and rampant accretions were just some of the major challenges that required urgent professional intervention. In August 2013, the Hindu Religious and Charitable Endowments Department, Tamil Nadu, appointed the Indian Culture and Heritage Trust and the Venugopalaswamy Kaingariyam Trust, Chennai, as the principal agency to undertake a major conservation project at the Sri Ranganatha Swami Temple. The aim of the conservation project was to restore, conserve, manage, protect, and preserve the rich architectural heritage, and to make every space of the temple complex accessible to all devotees to pursue their ritual practice as was intended over 5 centuries ago. Around 50,000 tons of debris had to be removed to expose the glory of the original structures. With a multidisciplinary team of 1,330, comprising sthapatis, engineers, architects, conservationists, historians, archaeologists, artists, craft persons, maintenance staff, as well as key members of the HR and CE department and of the local community, this tremendously challenging project, which started in June 2014, was completed in a record time of 16 months. Strictly following the rules laid down in the Agamic Shastras, the restoration was completed using similar materials and techniques to maintain the same prime dimensions as those of the original structures.
Dum 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 dum.
The objective of the project was to integrate the restored heritage site into the daily lives of devotees in a manner that was wholly meaningful. Following the completion of this challenging project, the Srirangana Swami Temple stands restored to its original glory as an architectural wonder and the spiritual, cultural, economic, community binding fulcrum that it was intended to be. The project, which aimed to preserve antiquity for posterity, has resulted in this temple being considered for inclusion in the prestigious World Heritage List. In recognition of the professional excellence adopted by the team, the project was awarded the prestigious UNESCO Award of Merit at the UNESCO Asia Pacific Awards for Cultural Heritage Conservation in 2017.